know that you're a phoenix, so rise up from all those ashes today. Yeah, you've been scarred, but you a czar, you can crawl into the grave. I know you know that a lion's inside, sleeping in your heart. Step back and remember who you are.
What up, Pride? It's your boy Mari, back again with another reaction video. Today, we're getting into another Stray Kids funny compilation, funny moments, chaotic moments video. Because I recently reacted to one of these, and the entire comment section was like, yeah, Chief, this ain't it. This video is not great. You reacted to the wrong one. Like I was just choosing to react to the bad video. But everybody was like, nah, this one isn't good. And so people gave me some recommendations. This is one of the recommendations that they gave me. This video is 8 billion years long. So, should probably not make this intro that long. So, if you're new here, thanks for watching. I have a bunch of other Stray Kids reaction videos. Definitely make sure to go check those out on the channel. Hit the subscribe button. Do all the stuff. You didn't see the YouTube video before. This is not your first rodeo on YouTube. So do all the stuff because I desperately need it. And yeah, let's get into this video. I appreciate you guys watching. I'll see you guys on the other side.
여기 다양한 잼이 있는데 조금 어떻게 될지 모르겠어요. 스테이지 잼입니다. 시큼한 맛.
그 아이면 가수인데
다릅니다.
그는 배우 본인은 가수다.
어 맞아요.
가수 이제 작품 뭐 하는데?
작품 저 지금 스트레이키즈 하고 있습니다.
드라마야? 영화야?
네.
괜히는 그러면 솔로 가수야?
저도 그룹 하고 있습니다.
아 그 그룹 이름이 어떻게 되노?
스트레이키즈입니다.
스트레이키즈?
네. 아, 저도 가수인데요.
배우라면?
가수라고 했는데.
If Stray Kids had a twerk off, who'd win? This is a serious scientific experiment.
Chan이랑 찬이 형이
유리한
거. No! But Chan has a big
butt.
Fat.
Butt.
Fat.
I reacted to this particular video. I'm pretty sure I saw this video. That's 100% sure. I think I reacted to it though. Go if you haven't seen my face laughing at this, then go check my channel and see if I'm gaslighting you right now, like Soonmin. Maybe I am. I don't know. But I definitely saw this video and it was absolutely hilarious. I feel like I did because I feel like I remember getting comments of people being like, I didn't expect you to react to this. Oh my goodness. I'm so happy that you reacted to this. And I was like, I didn't expect to react to this either, but I was going to watch it. So might as well turn the camera on. You know, I feel like this channel gives me a good excuse to watch these kinds of things and just be like, oh, I'm just doing my job. Like, no, that was for me. I wanted to see. But also, hold on. There's also a video where they're like roasting each other. They're like going back and forth, like trying to roast each other. And whoever laughs, it like switches out the member. I don't know if I reacted to that or if I just watched it on my own. Point is, as you can see, I've been consuming some auxiliary Stray Kids content, and I've been enjoying myself, obviously, because I'm making this video here. But if that wasn't clear, I've been enjoying myself. The boys are insane.
Chan has a big
butt.
Fat.
Butt.
Fat. Yeah.
Has a big bum. Nah, but I think Changbin Young can do it better.
Ah, Changbin do 잘 것 같아. 한번 여기
try.
Try.
Chris,
he can talk better than me. I lose.
I hope we like spicy food.
No, I don't.
No. Who has the best spice tolerance?
From Lino.
This man has
1 to 10. What would it be?
11.
11.
Watch.
And Chan also. He loves spicy food.
Yeah. -11. Yeah. -11.
우리 한번 토론 좀 할까?
네.
무슨 일이십니까?
드디어 정치 얘기하시는 건가?
닭이 먼저 할까? 달걀이 먼저 할까?
닭도 거기에는 공룡이었잖아.
어.
공룡이 계란에서 태어나지 않았을까?
그 알은 누가 낳는데?
서창빈.
그 안쪽 거세.
창빈이 형이 낳았어.
그러니까 알처럼
꽃이 있잖아. 근데 어쨌든 그 꽃이 올라오려면 씨가 있어야 되잖아. 그럼 그 씨가 어디서 나왔을까?
씨가 어디서 나왔어? 꽃에서 나왔지.
그 꽃은 어디서 나왔는데?
꽃은 씨에서 나왔지.
그럼 씨는 어디서 나왔을까?
씨는 꽃에서 나왔지.
그러면 닭은?
닭은?
계란에서 나왔지.
닭은 계란은? 계란은 닭에서 나왔지.
그렇지.
그러니까 뭐가 먼저야?
모르겠다 이거.
알은 닭이 나왔다니까? 근데 그 닭은 알에서 나온 거잖아.
근데 그 닭은 알에서 나왔다.
재미 들렸다.
닭이랑 달걀 가지고 토론하는 멤버들을 보고 무슨 생각을 하셨나요?
아 맞네, 그거 했었구나. 저 먹느라고
여덟 명 다 같이.
Okay, so I know none of you guys care about my thoughts on this, but I'm gonna share them anyway. First off, before we get to that, does Bang Chan actually like spicy food or not like? Was he being humble or does he not like spicy food and his members were setting him up because they know that? I'm curious. This is that is very important. Okay, so that's its own separate matter. Now to the unimportant matter. This chicken and the egg thing has always been interesting to me because for a long time I felt like the answer was really obvious, which you might be like, obvious? How is it obvious if people are debating all the time? It's obvious because it really depends on what you believe in. If you believe in like creationism, like a deity created everything, then the answer is obviously whatever your religion says was created. So if your religion says that it was the chicken that was created, so say like Christianity, so obviously the chicken came first in that situation. Or I guess if your religion says that like everything started as the baby animals, then it would be the egg, right? Okay, if you look at it from a different standpoint, if you're looking at it from the standpoint of science, then evolution would say that the egg came first. Because the thing that had the first chicken that ever existed, had a parent that wasn't all the way a chicken. It was something else. It was one mutation away from a chicken, right? And it laid an egg. That egg hatched and became a chicken, as we now know it, right? Now, obviously, evolution takes a way longer time than that. But the point is that in that thought process, the egg comes first. No matter how long you would say that process takes, as far as like evolutionary speaking, the egg would have to come first because the thing that laid the egg that would then become the first chicken, like its parent, was not all the way a chicken. Now you would then have to like make a distinction on like what qualifies all the way as a chicken and 99.999% chicken, but not chicken all the way yet. Okay, that's not my job. I'm not a scientist. But the point is that in that scenario, the egg would come first. But if you're religious and specifically from a religion that like has like a creation myth, if you look at that like creation story, there will be some explanation to the chicken and egg thing if you just kind of think about it for a little bit. So I've always found this debate really fascinating because I feel like most people already have their answer to it and yet they still debate about it. Does that make sense? It's like, now if you're debating, if you're like an evolutionary person debating with a person who's like coming from a standpoint of creationism, that's one thing, but I've never seen this debate had where it's like that. It's not a religion versus science debate. And not all religions are like counter science, and not all subsects of the same religion are counter science. But you get what I'm saying. This debate is always like, I don't know. Like, it's never like, people don't ever really get into the minutia of it. And I've always just found that so interesting because for whatever reason to me, it just seemed rather blatant that most people would have their answer. I even know religious people who believe in evolution, and even in that scenario you have your answer. And so I'm just like, why is this confusing to everybody? Not in a condescending way, but like in a genuinely curious way. Like, if this is a question that is confusing to you, can you explain to that? I mean, I guess that's kind of a dumb thing to ask. Like, hey, why are you confused about a thing that you're confused about? But if you can, explain to me why this is confusing to you. Because I feel like most people, they have some belief on how everything got to where it is today. And in that belief, there is an answer to this particular debate. Now, why did the chicken cross the road? That debate, I understand. I'm saying. No, but for real though, this particular debate always fascinates me, and I find it to be like one of the most common debates, or not even debates, but just like one of the most common conversations. But when people have it, it is almost always like not talked about in the way that I think makes the answer obvious. And so I don't know if I'm just like that weird of a dude that I'm like, you have an answer to this, and people are like, no, I don't. It's so confusing. And I'm just like, but you do. And if you answer this other question over here, I can actually tell you what your answer to this question is. I'm confused at everybody else's confusion, I guess. And that's not to say that nobody has an answer to this. I know a bunch of people who have an answer to this. I know some people who have an answer to, like, just off vibes. They just be like, I don't know. I just feel like that's the answer. So that's the answer. And I'm like, okay, cool. But yeah. This was a like surprisingly long rant, huh? But I needed to take this moment and ask everybody, like, I missed the memo on the confusion of this question. And I would really like to understand other people not understanding it. That's such a weirdly worded sentence. But okay, let's continue.
여덟 명 다 같이 선글라스 쓰고 연습하게 할 건데. 직궁. 댄스를 준비를 했는데 네.
이번에 뭐 또 준비한 게 있어요?
우리 스트레이 키즈의 명곡 매니악을 또 준비를 5, 6, 7, 8 매니악
프랑켄스트라이크처럼
매니아 매니아 오 갓 너무 지금까지 뭐 약간 리믹스 아니면 커버 매니아 있었는데 어우 게이 버전은 처음 보시네요.
그럼 INC가 걸릴 벌칙은?
IN의 형들에게
INA 형들에게 뽀뽀하기.
아 이거!
아 이엔아!
야 이거 해야지!
아 이엔아!
그건 해야지 근데!
해라!
뽀뽀 당할래 아니면 할래?
진짜 너무 싫다. 아 싫어! 아니 왜 이렇게 뽀뽀를 말해!
이 수술 한번 맞아볼래?
할래!
당하기 아니면 해주기.
안 할 거면 노래 불러.
노래?
아니 해 그냥! 뽀뽀뽀 하지! 뽀뽀뽀! 뽀뽀 불러! 뽀뽀 그거 기억해 한번 불러.
들이 출근할 때 뽀뽀뽀!
더해!
형들이 밥 먹어도
뽀뽀뽀
형들이 잠들었을
뽀뽀뽀
릴라이킷은 자꾸 큰 사람들이 진짜 나쁜 사람들이에요.
너를 책임질 수 없지만
아니야 그런 뜻이 아니라고! 처음에 썸인 관계가 좋다.
이제는 창빈이 형이 던졌어.
내가요?
형이 네. 던졌잖아요.
많은 분들이 되게 공감할 만한
아사로가 하면 안 되나요?
아니 환승연애를 보고 많은 또 노래가 있잖아 한씨가
아 13
지금 다이 커플
다 사귄대요!
그럼 했다 봤어!
세 개나 봤어요! 플라로이드 그거 인스타에다
알로 왔구나!
동진이 형! 그니까 그 15주년 되면 15주년도 또 써드릴게요. 그냥 쭉 사귀어주세요.
트렌드 좀 따라주세요.
밤의 연애가
저도 진짜 맞아요.
현진이 형
현진
나 서창빈!
현진이라니까 나 이거 민호만 진짜 얘 나한테 거짓말 못하는 애야!
아 쟤야
진짜 승민이 아니야 제발 나 좀 믿어봐!
그럼 그 옆에 방찬!
아 왜 나야?
너 형 나 아니야.
왜?
여러분들한테 거짓말을 할 수 없어.
지금 거짓말 치고 있는데?
너다!
아닙니다.
아 맞네. 아.
Here, please look up and reveal yourself.
근데 스키즈가 콘서트에서 그렇게 많이 울던데 왜 그렇게 우는지 혹시 물어봐도 될까?
아 갑자기? 아 우리가 콘서트에서 아 그만 감동이 있으니까 왜 콘서트 때 안 울어?
울지.
넌 울 때 무슨 기분으로 우는데?
어 이 사람들은 왜 내가 뭐라고 또 이렇게 아.
She looks familiar, but I don't know who this is. Tell me who this is. Obviously, like a musician of some kind, because he's asking her about concerts. She's talking about fans giving her love. I'm sure she's super talented. I may have like even seen her somewhere at some point, but she just looks familiar to me. So let me know who this person is, please, and thank you. 아.
이런 사랑을 줄까?
아, 왜? 또 왜 그렇게 생각을 해? 얼마나 특별하고, 얼마나.
아, 또 전 창비 오빠 우는 걸 본 적이 없어요.
그치. 운 적이 없지, 네 앞에서, 그지?
왜 안 울어?
나 잘 안 울어. 멤버들 앞에서도 잘 안 울고.
전 진짜 추한 꼴을 정말 많이 보였어요, 오빠한테.
아, 안 추했어. 뭘 추해. 추한 적은 없어. 추했던 적은 없는데. 약간 얘가 좀 울거나, 그럼 진짜 서럽게 불쌍하게 울거든요.
는 뭐. 케미가 잘 맞나 보다. 회사에서 어디 뭐 예능 프로나 뭐 이런 거 있으면 꼭 둘이 묶어서.
아니, 케미 안 맞아가지고 이번에 처음입니다.
케미 안 맞는데 둘이 묶어서 내한테 보낸 거야?
네. 그걸 믿고 이제 JYP에서.
JYP.
그거 좀 안 했으면 좋겠어요.
Strike his love. This is Jisung's volume. Minhyun just like.
No.
Oh, why not?
Why?
I don't agree.
Why not?
제이 승민이가 작은 사람?
김승민.
승민.
플랭크랑 푸시업을 왜 접으신 거예요?
사실 그래서 좀 쉬운 거 뭐 일본 플랭크 하기 아니면 좀 건강에 대해서 아, 좋은 거를 많이 두 개를 추천했죠.
승민이가 늘 약간 마초적이고 무대에서 보면 와 이렇게 근육도 다 키도 확실하고 근데 뭐가 있어?
아, 예, 아쉽게도 안타깝죠. 유일한 결점이죠 우리 리더.
왜 이렇게 결점이야 그게?
그게 보시죠. 아침에 막 일어나가지고 머리가 뭐 초사연처럼 막 이렇게 돼 있고 막 진짜 되게 음영고수. 아니 일어났죠? 이러면 되게 아침에 일어나자마자 그렇게 키.
아, 그거다. 뭐 아빠 바이브.
아, 이놀장님 나오셨잖아요.
아, 맞아요.
어?
여기에 계실 모든 분들 비밀로 해주세요.
잠깐 카메라 좀 꺼주세요. SD카드 주세요.
Oh, straight away. One of my favorite thing about this is Marvel has no idea I did that.
Really?
That's part of the fun.
What happened to the bit with us?
You have no idea how many people sent me this exact video. Like, I wouldn't have watched it 5 times already on my own. You guys have no faith in me. And I am so, so disturbed, perturbed, in other terms, that you guys would just assume that I hadn't seen. I got like 50 people who sent this. They're like, I don't know if you've seen it. Look here, Mr. and Mrs. and other. I don't know what the they, them version of Mr. and Mrs. is. But that's not the point right now, okay? The point is, y'all should know me better, okay? Y'all should know that I know you're trying to help, but, and also don't stop helping, because in the future you might send me something. You might be the only person to send it to me, and I would have never seen it otherwise. So, like, I really do appreciate it. Please do continue. But look here, okay? I saw it, okay? I watched it like 7 times, and every time somebody sends it to me, I'd click on it again, because why not? You know, it don't hurt. So, yeah, this was madness. This was insane. Also, it was a patting on the back competition. They were just both like, oh, I'm so honored to be in your presence. And the other was like, no, I'm honored to be in your presence. Yeah, it was great. It was good vibes. That wasn't supposed to be funny, but that's, and now that I'm thinking about it, that's actually really fun. It was really hilarious. Also, you can't really have Ryan Reynolds anywhere without it being like, pure comedy. That dude is like chaos incarnate.
Oh, straight away.
One of my favorite thing about this is Marvel has no idea I did that.
Really?
That's part of the fun.
What happened to the bit with us dancing that we thought was in? Remember we did?
They took one look at that and.
Why?
Come on.
Why would you cut it out?
아니 저 준준이가 참 귀여워요.
메이크업도 너무 마음에 드는 게 또 주근깨 포인트를 하셨네요.
진짜 어떻게 알았지?
저랑 너무 비슷한 것 같아요.
위치를 정확하게 알고 있으니까요.
아, 사진 제가 너무 많이 버블로 보냈나 봐요.
네, 고화질로 보내주니까 여러분 4,500원의 행복을 이어가세요.
You guys have really good spice tolerance. You think that's not...
Okay, wait, hold on. I like that this video gives additional context to the scenes and also their subs. So like I can follow along with this video way more than the last one, but I need to understand. Did the interviewer like do her makeup freckles to match the placement of his actual freckles? Did she do her makeup freckles to match the placement of his makeup freckles? Or did I completely misunderstand the entire freckle makeup conversation that was happening there? Please inform me in the comment section down below, because I feel like it has to be one of those three options. There is no other, because the third one literally covers everything else. So it's one of those three. I'm right a bit is what I'm saying, but how much right am I? That's not a sentence, but it is today. So comment section down below. Thank you. Okay, let's continue.
You guys have really good spice tolerance. You think that's not spicy? Okay, 방찬 씨 막 죽으려고 그래 지금.
Oh yeah.
It's the perfect bite.
예, 뭐 양이랑 막창이랑 고추.
Do you guys have a ritual before you go on stage?
Oh yeah, we do.
Yeah, what's the ritual?
We all huddle up and. Okay. We all go hello and we go hiding.
그냥 되죠. 전에 곡 하나 써달라고 부탁했는데 빠른 시간 안에 그렇게 완성도 있는 곡을 써줄 줄 몰랐다.
어 졸려. 노래가 많이 늘었더구나. 내 곡도 잘.
아 졸려. 밥 언제지?
어제 사서 먹었어.
야. 몇 살인?
24살.
애기인가? 남자인가? 똑같아. 뭐 몸은? 아, 남자.
뭐 어떻게 지내셨어요?
자리요.
네?
진짜 궁금해서 여쭤보시는 거 아니에요? 방송이에요?
네, 알죠. 상배 씨는 방송용이랑 그냥 대답이 나뉘어 있나요?
맞죠. 나뉘어, 아니죠. 안 나뉘어 있죠. 방송이랑 이게 앞뒤가 다른 사람이 있으면 안 되죠. 다른 사람, 사람은 그렇게 다르면
안 되죠. 확실히 다르죠.
네, 다르긴 해요.
개인 비주얼은 누구죠?
창빈! 오! 이게 왜 정답이에요? 넘어가!
So when's the Fool's 3 Racha album coming out? Please!
JYP! What are you doing?
우리의 3 Racha 앨범이 나오려면 Stray Kids 앨범이 미뤄지지 않을까요?
No! No!
넌 둘 다 할 수 있어.
Work harder, 창빈!
쉽지 않아.
Let me join in 3 Racha.
Oh, no, no, oh, then you won't have a job.
You all lose that. I lose my job.
어쨌든 이번 앨범이 나왔는데 아, 최고입니다. 최고.
그냥 Mountains 되게 좋아한 것 같아.
Mountains 말고 또 최고.
Runners.
Runners 말고 그 또 있잖아요. 또 최고.
Like that.
그거 말고 이제 또 되게 좋은 노래 하나 더 있긴 하거든요.
아 그 진짜 좋은 노래.
아, 예. 아
네. 솔직히 칙칙뽕 네. 제일 사랑합니다.
그리고
뽕뽕뽕.
그리고 있잖아요. 진짜 좋은 노래 하나 더 있잖아요.
스트레이키즈 노래라는 노래 있죠. 아 예. 잼 잼이라는 노래도 있죠. 잼.
찍고 마지막으로 진짜 좋은 노래 하나 더 있긴.
아그 칙칙뽕 페스티벌 버전.
예. 아, 예. 맞습니다. 진짜 좋은 노래가. 예. 정말 좋은 노래죠.
Okay, all right, hold on. I'm gonna hear the rest of this in a second, but I need to say, if y'all haven't seen my Twilight reaction, which is most of y'all, because that's like the least viewed reaction from the whole album, I need y'all to put some respect on this song name. This song is incredible. Easily a top five Stray Kids song for me ever. It's amazing. I've played it an ungodly amount of times at this point. I love that song so much. It's impeccable. Like there's nothing bad about that song from start to finish. It's perfection. Amazing. Okay. I also learned what Han Pop was in the process of reacting to that. So that was great. But this question, I would love if they did this for every comeback. I don't know if they do. Maybe they do. And with every member, where they like ask them like, hey, what's your top three favorite songs off of the project, like going through each of them, because I feel like that would be so fascinating, especially if we could get a why. You guys know me, I always like to talk about music and talk about songs, talk to people who make music, so on and so forth, and just like get people's perspective on things. Even with my own music, I'm always asking you guys, like, hey, what's your favorite song? Rank them. How do you feel about these songs? Why? Like, you know, I like to discuss music. That's why I do this channel, because it's definitely not the money. So for me, this like style of conversation, even though it's like joking, it's super interesting to me that like his go-to answer was mountains. I would love to know why Felix loves mountains so much. Not that the song is bad, but like, what about mountains for you was better than Jajam? I know that's not what it's called, but it's what it's called on this channel. Or Chick Chick Boom, or Stray Kids, or Twilight, which is again impeccable. Or like, did you get what I'm saying? Like, what drew you to that song in particular? If you guys have a favorite song from this project, or top three, or whatever, and you'd like to discuss it in the comment section down below, please leave that down there. I'd spend all day talking to you guys about your favorite songs on the project. Why? If you just want to like rank them from top to bottom, I would love to hear you guys' rankings. I love these kinds of conversations so much, and their music is really, really good, so I get how that could be difficult, but like talking to the creators of the music to hear their favorite songs, if you've ever sat and listened to artists in interviews talk about their favorite songs from themselves, it's never what the fans think. Like their favorite song of a project or their favorite song in their catalog is usually not the quote-unquote fan favorite or most popular song from that artist. In fact, there are artists who straight up hate their most popular song, in part because they have to perform it like all the time, or they become known for that song if they're a one-hit wonder. But you get what I'm saying. Just because the fans love a song does not mean that the artist loves the song to that same degree, and vice versa. And so, very interesting conversation. Okay, let's go back some.
버전 또 있죠.
맞습니다. 진짜 좋은 노래야. Ah, 좋은 노래죠.
사랑한다.
최애곡이야.
당연히 칙칙봉입니다.
첫째는
마운틴스로 하겠습니다.
세 번째는
잼으로 하겠습니다.
세 번째는
또 다시 밤 언제 나오나 물어본다.
브라네스.
다섯 번째는
칙칙봉 페스티벌 버전.
아, 그렇죠.
여기까지 하겠습니다.
여섯 번째는
일곱 번째는
Where's Twilight? Hey, Where's Twilight? My song Twilight.
Hold on. Sorry. Did he just change his order? From when he was talking to that happens sometimes. So I'm just okay. I have to go back and this video is already long. You knew that when you clicked on it. Don't judge me, okay? This is important information that I am getting here, okay?
Mountains 되게 좋아한 것 같아.
Mountains 말고 또 최고.
Runners.
Runners 말고 그 또 있잖아. 또 최고.
Like that.
그거 말고 이제 또 되게 좋은 노래 하나 더 있긴 하거든.
아 그 진짜 좋은 노래.
아, 예. 아
네. 솔직히 칙칙봄 네. 제일 사랑합니다.
그리고
뽕뽕뽕.
그리고 있잖아요. 진짜 좋은 하나 더 있잖아요.
스트레이키즈라는 노래 있죠. 아 예. 잼 잼이라는 노래도 있죠. 잼.
진짜 마지막으로 진짜 좋은 노래 하나 더 있긴.
아 그 칙칙봄 페스티벌 버전 하나 더
예.
있죠.
아, 예. 맞습니다. 진짜 좋은 노래야. 예. 아, 정말 좋은 노래죠.
네, 하.
사랑한다.
최애곡이야.
아, 당연히 칙칙봉입니다.
첫째는
마운틴스로 하겠습니다.
세 번째는
잼으로 하겠습니다.
네 번째는
또 다시 밤 언제 나오나 물어본다.
브라네스.
다섯 번째는
칙칙봉 페스티벌 버전.
아, 그렇죠.
여기까지 하겠습니다.
여섯 번째는
일곱 번째는
Where's Twilight? Hey, Where's Twilight? My song Twilight.
코터를 한 다섯 가닥을 잡아가지고 팍 뺀다고 되게 아플 거 아니야?
나는 아이돌에서 코터를 없어.
야, 씨! 화장실을 올해부터 가기 시작했거든.
아직도 좌변기가 어떻게 생긴지 모르겠어.
나는 이렇게 휴대전화 봤었어가지고.
아, 화장실이 뭐지?
오, 아무튼 이거야.
사막은 밤 되면 진짜 추워요. 어떤 거 같아요?
형, 새끼 발가락 움직일 수 있어?
어? 못하는 것 같은데. 다시 해봐. 빠르네.
승희 형 가슴 이뻐요. 이인이 가슴 이뻐요. 창빈 형 가슴 이쁩니다. 리누은 가슴 이쁘고요. 승민이는 가슴이 없습니다.
서창빈도 있고 목에 가면 서창빈도 있고 현진이도 있고
붕어빵도 있고
승민이도 있고
필릭스도 있고
계곡에 가면 서창빈도 있고 현진이도 있고 붕어빵도 있고 또 누가 있더라.
계곡에 가면 게임 진 이유가 뭐라고 생각하세요?
이게 나이를 먹어갈수록 조금씩 이제 조금 뇌세포가 떨어지고 있지 않나.
형 괜찮아, 형 괜찮아.
좋았어, 좋았어. 한 번만 더 들어볼게요.
보여줄게, 가자. 카빗은 카메라를 쏜다, 명중한다. 카메라 다 왔을 때 살짝 눈빛. 눈빛 딱 주면은 끝. 이야.
붐, 붐, 집, 집.
세희한테 인사해.
안녕하세요.
매운 거 먹으면서 한 번만 애교 좀. 아,
그래. 진짜 너무 맵다.
So cute.
아, 진짜 맵다.
너무 맛있어.
포케.
포케가 왜 포케예요?
포켓몬이 먹어서.
그냥 노동.
수도 한 번만 앞으로 돌아주세요.
오케이.
뭐 리더 입장에서 봤을 때 말 더럽게 안 듣네.
다
잘 안 듣긴 해 우리가.
We have a Korean barbecue etiquette.
막창 맛있겠다.
Okay, anyone else?
고기에 대한 예의가 좀 필요해서 오, 진짜 신중하게 잘 구워줘야 돼.
오케이, 오케이.
가시는 게 굳게 가시게.
예의가.
Are you a good cook?
어, 예, 예.
Yeah, he's a good cook.
네, 그리고 현진 씨.
네네네.
네, 오늘 팬분들을 위해서 준비하신 게 있다고요.
아, 네. 아, 또 우리 예쁜 스테이를 위해서 저희가 귀여운 애교를 한번 준비해봤습니다. 하나, 둘, 셋. 귀여운.
절반이나 지났는데 올해 이룬 목표가 있나요? 그리고 아직 이루지 못한 목표가 있다면 무엇인가요?
이루지 못했습니다. 형님들과 여행을 가는 것이었는데.
맞아, 형님. 가자, 가야지.
가자,
가야지.
가자. 가자.
가자.
크라스 스케줄 빼주십시오.
오늘 늦지 않았어.
앨범 컨셉과는 조금 맞지 않지만, 네. 자, 개인 촬영은 왼쪽 정면 오른쪽 이렇게 진행하도록 하겠습니다. 자, 먼저 왼쪽. 왼쪽. 오, 좋아요.
스키즈는 하나다, 아니면 여덟이다.
하나지,
하나지.
스키즈 여덟이지.
너 혼자 스키즈 아니에요?
스키즈는 팀이잖아.
여덟이 아닌 스키즈가 아니기 때문에.
왜?
천연 동굴 목소리를 녹음할 겁니다. 뭐가 멘트죠 여기다가. 아, 석천이 형 사랑해요.
아, 오케이, 오케이, 좋아요. 석천이 형 사랑해요.
석천이 형 사귈래요? 한 번만 해줘.
네?
석천이 형 사귈래요? 빨리 여기.
아, 죄송합니다.
아, 뭘 아, 죄송해.
아, 죄송합니다.
야, 호가.
아, 죄송합니다. 아, 네, 안녕하세요. 네, 고생했습니다. 고생했습니다.
Hope you guys enjoyed as well. And yeah, hope to see you next time as well.
Yeah, yeah. It was great.
It was very great. It was good. It was perfect. It was perfect.
Huh? It's perfect, boy.
It was perfect. It was beautiful, huh?
Yeah. Thank you for coming. Thank you for watching this video.
아, 가라고요.
아, 가라고요.
Okay, so that was great. It was great. I don't know what you want me to say. I do agree that video was much better than the last one. That video said in the title that there is a part two. No, okay, it didn't say this, but it implied that there is a part two because that says part one. So if you guys are interested in seeing me react to part two, let me know in the comment section down below. This video went all over the place, but I mean, hey, that's why you watch these videos, right? I definitely had a good time. There were certain moments where I was just laughing and they were just like looking. Like it was just like Bang Chan looking at the camera and I was laughing. So definitely funny, definitely chaotic. Very, very interesting. I love watching this like auxiliary non-musical content because it really gives you a greater appreciation for the music because you understand them as people better, which helps you understand them as artists better. Yeah, really enjoyed it. So thank you so much for being here. Definitely make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share not to miss any more content like this. Much more Stray Kids content coming in the future. So definitely make sure to hit that subscribe button not to miss out on any of that content. And I'll be seeing all of you guys here on the channel next time. Have a great day. Peace. These guys know blues. A new love, but we know that it accrues. Like time in a queue at shampoo, new bamboo. Much more of it will ensue. I'm caught in this trancing loop of sinking down in the stew. You change up the brew, now life tastes so brand new. It's delicious like fondue. Under the moonlight tonight, stars and hearts shimmering. Shimmering, you illuminate who I am. You're a bad light. You are my midnight.